Hello. Right. Thought I'd do this blog thing because my partner and I have just moved from Bristol to Jersey in the Channel Islands. So for you people out there who don't know where Jersey in the Channel Islands is, it's an island near France, but it's sort of independent, but it's a crown protectorate of the UK. So they worship the Queen as a god or goddess, and I think we provide the military to protect them, and they provide some banking or something to the UK. I don't really know. And potatoes. They grow potatoes. Right, so we can do more Jersey facts as we go on with the blog. So potatoes, cows, and banking, I think. So here we are. We've rented a house. We had to do this all on WhatsApp. That made things a bit trickier in finding somewhere. But yeah, the reason why we couldn't visit Jersey to look at anywhere because of COVID, we'd have had to quarantine. Where am I looking? We'd have had to quarantine, so we just did it all on a WhatsApp call, which was a bit stressful. I haven't got a clue, and why I'm not allowed to leave the house, I don't know. Surely I could go for a walk and not see anyone, but that's up to the wisdom of the King of Jersey, or the Queen of Jersey, in fact. So here we are. Things we brought with us. Couple of rugs because it was a wooden floor. Got a table, telly that came with the house. As you can see, free furniture there. I don't know if you can see that settee. Kiara got it for free on probably Amazon, no, not Amazon, Facebook Marketplace. There's a fair bit of furniture on there, but some of it's quite expensive, some of it's a bit dodgy. But this one, a lovely lady gave us this lovely city for free. We brought a camping table and two camping chairs, so we had somewhere to sit. We're eating, still using that, and we have a kitchen, so we brought a kettle. We don't like the taste of the water here, so we're sort of gonna get a water filter. We're relying on two of those Kilner jars to put water in, bottled unfortunately, but recycle the bottles. A SodaStream to save on plastic bottles. We brought a microwave with us, that's been very useful. Toaster, some pots and pans and cutlery. We chucked all that in the camper van when we came over, and it just about fitted. A blender to make oat milk. And but yeah, this is the view I've seen of Jersey so far. And we have a little garden. There we go. Kiara managed to get some bamboo for some bizarre reason. And the guy, to fit it in his van, chopped the top off it to fit it in. Probably thought it's fine to chop the bamboo in half to fit it in the van or his car or whatever it was. So, bit concerned about that. A bit concerned about buying any furniture in case the person who wants to deliver it thinks it's okay to maybe cut the table in half to fit it into the van, or maybe cut the legs off chairs to fit it in. But you know, you've got to fit in with the locals. So, this house has got about 100 toilets. I managed to wee in every single one so far, which is pretty good going. So aside from the camping table, we're a bit short of furniture. Other things to think about when you're moving to Jersey, if you're going to move to Jersey, if you're allowed to move to Jersey. So, floor drobe, usual. It's always like this, to be honest. Whether it's got a wardrobe or not, it's a floor drobe. So, the other thing is, we bought some of these little blind things from IKEA. They've been good for keeping heating because it's absolutely freezing at the moment. The beast from the east is coming through Jersey. Not exactly, it's very cold. And it's the other thing with Jersey, you haven't got proper heating here. It's a little bit like New Zealand. It's not particularly warm, but the idea of proper heating doesn't seem to have found its way to Jersey yet. So there's a lot of these things, which you can see is a little electric heater that plugs in. And it looks like it came from like the 1960s. I think that might be made of Bakelite or something. It's probably considered quite modern out here. Another toilet over there. But yeah, but that bed that came in the van, and all the bedding and that. And just a note on things like the bedding, stuff like this, duvets and whatnot. We used a lot of those compression sacks that you vacuum. So you chuck it in a plastic bag and you put the vacuum on it and it sucks all the air out, or you get a little pump and you pump it and it sucks all the air out. It still remains quite heavy, it doesn't reduce the weight, but it reduces the air from it and it compresses it down into a smaller thing. And the ones we bought, I think about six out of the packet burst. My electric tariff, so we've got something called Comfort Heat, because it's all electric. So we get 8.6p from 1:26 in the morning to 5:26 in the morning. I don't know why it's 26. And then from 10:56 to 12:56, it's that cheap price. And then from 8:26 to 10:26 is that price. And then you get a low period of 11.6p from 11pm to 7am. And then a normal period from 7am to 11pm. So during the day, 15.6. But your Comfort Heat only applies to, I think it might be your boiler and your storage heaters. I don't know how they work. And this is sort of one nice thing about Jersey, is you phone up Jersey Electric and you get through to a human being quite quickly, which isn't like the UK, you don't have to wait for ages. And also I said to them, I don't know how the heater works. And they said, well, we normally send someone around to teach you how to use it. And it's like, what? Yeah, we'll send a nice man or woman round and they'll teach you how to use your heater and your boiler. But we can do it over the phones because of COVID. And we can teach you how to use your heating and hot water thing, which is quite incredible, really. We're finding this quite a lot in Jersey. There's lots of nice little friendly things, lots of quirky things as well. And yeah, it's all part of going into what could be a foreign country or whatever it is. So yeah, I'm sure this is very boring talking about energy tariffs, but yeah, it's the kind of thing you may want to know when you're moving over here. And I'm sure Kiara's got lots of stuff to say about a driving licenses, car registration, insurance, I guess, because you're in a foreign country, insurance for driving might only be valid for a certain number of days. But we'll cover that in the next exciting episode of Gary and Kiara Move to Jersey. Where do I look?